Hello again. Welcome back. Billy Ashbaugh. I'm here in the drum room, and today we're going to talk about halftime and double time grooves. Now, when you're listening to music and it goes into a halftime feel, chances are it's going to create the illusion that it's almost slowing down. And likewise, when it goes into a double time feel, it can create the illusion that it's actually speeding up. This is not really happening, though. What's going on is the quarter note stays rock solid throughout this as the groove sort of shifts around. So before we can get inside of what's going on in halftime and double time, let's look at the quarter note pulse. I like to give this analogy. Visualize cement post, okay? That's your quarter note pulse. They're rock solid and they're structured. They don't move at all, okay? To understand what we're gonna get into, halftime and double time, all we have to really have a knowledge for is how to count eighth notes. And all we're gonna do is stick one note spaced evenly in between and just count one and two and three and four and. So for your regular groove, for your halftime groove, for your double time groove, the hi-hat is going to continue to play eighth notes. That's going to sort of glue this together while we're learning this concept. So here's your regular groove with the snare drum on two and four. Okay, pretty basic stuff. Now, what we're going to do to set up this halftime feel, hi-hat stays the same. All we're gonna do is shift the snare drum. Instead of two and four, play beat three only. We're gonna let some of the pattern of the kick drum drop out, be a little more spacious. It's gonna sound more spacious, but remember, it's still in time. Listen to the click track. Okay, now let's look at double time. Here the snare drum is going to shift and play every and or every upbeat. The quarter note is now going to be felt on the kick drum. I'm going to play all four quarter notes on the kick drum, hit every and or upbeat on the snare. It's going to really let this thing chug forward. Again, pay attention to the hi-hat. I'm still just doing eighth notes. Okay, one more thing I like to share with you, something I like to do for the double time groove, is I like to play the first two 16th notes for beat two and beat four. It also helps propel this groove along pretty well. Okay, now I'd like to give you one more example. I'm going to play all three grooves within the same setting. Here's the formula. 4 bars of regular time, 4 bars of half time, 4 bars back into regular time, 4 bars of double time, and then I'm going to finish up with 4 bars of regular time. Alright, so the next time you're listening to music and it seems to change on you, slow down or speed up, don't panic, just listen to that quarter note pulse, pay attention to where the snare drum's hitting, and you'll do fine. We'll see you guys next time.